Hi everyone, I'm Doug Cartwright for Guitar Interactive magazine, and today I'm here with three guitars from British boutique brand MacPherson. Dan MacPherson has been a luthier who's been on the scene and in this country for quite a few years now, and he's finally opened up his own line of guitars, and he's building them all by hand in his workshop, just by himself. So there's no CNC machines involved or any kind of modern manufacturing. It's all just one man working with basic tools and creating a complete line of instruments that should appeal to players of pretty much any style and genre. The three guitars that I've got here today that I'm going to be reviewing are all from his Pagan line. So the Pagan is kind of his modern guitar, the modern rock angled instrument that he's got. And the general spec of it that gives it that name is the body shape, the 24 fret setup, the headstock, that kind of thing. That's what makes it the Pagan. But because he's building them on his own, the specifications can absolutely change depending on kind of what the customer is looking for, and also really kind of depending on what he feels like building. So he's got three different levels. This is the standard model. So these are all standard Pagan guitars. Which he's created. So even though there's different pickups and different hardware on them, which I'll cover in a minute in more detail, he's also made, he also makes things like one-off custom, kind of private customs. So the one-off customs are just when he's building kind of a standard one, and then he decides, oh, I'll add something extra to this. So maybe he'll add flame maple tops or different wood combinations or something like that, just to make, you know, a kind of a standard custom guitar that would still be available from shops and from him direct. And then he'll do the private order customs, where you can get in touch with him if you like the look of his guitars, but you think that there's a specific thing that you would like changing. And you can really ask for almost anything from him, and he'll be able to modify the models that he's got to fit your specifications. So that would be a private order. But today, as I said, we're looking at his standard models. So these are the standard Pagans that I've got, and I'm going to run you through the specifications of this one that I've got here, the natural finish, and then I'll tell you a little bit about the differences that he's got and point out some of the things that commonly change and some of the different specs that he normally does in his standard line. Okay, so to start off with this one, this is our natural finish Pagan, and if I run you through from the top, up here we've got the standard MacPherson Pagan headstock, which is obviously a slightly modified, pretty classic design with a bit of a curve, and his logo. And on this model, and on most of the model, we've got the Goto tuners in black here. And coming across, I've got a graphite nut, which is again something that can change. But on this model, we've got the graphite nut, and it's all on this, the hard rock maple neck. There we go. With that one piece, all hand carved, beautifully, incredibly smooth, with a matte finish. And then if I turn it over, we've got a Palfaro fingerboard, which is a fancy rosewood, complete with stainless steel frets. And one feature that I particularly like on this guitar is that, and in fact on all of his guitars, is the fingerboards are bound. So I don't know if you can see that, but they're bound using the same wood as the fretboard. So the way he's building these is taking the neck blank that he's got and just shaving a bit of wood off either side before he starts, and then building the fretboard as normal, and then taking the wood that he had left over and binding them to make sure that you have no fret edges at all, no rough edges or anything like that. It's absolutely beautiful. I think it looks great. It's a lovely little detail on the guitar, and it's completely finished immaculately on both sides. It looks absolutely fantastic. So on this model, I've also got just standard white position markers on the side, and we've got the I believe that's abalone, or, oh no, I'm sorry, that's mother of pearl dots on the all the way up, position markers straight up to the 24th fret. So if we come across to the body, this is a two-piece swamp ash body with a natural finish. It's basically just a matte varnish over the top of the natural wood. If I turn it over so we can see the back, here we've got this cutaway that Dan's designed, which basically just thins it out all around the heel to make the access, the fret hand access, easier up here, like that. And it's really nice, it's really carved in perfectly, so it's very comfortable up at the top of the neck joint here. Got my full stretch in, and there's very little getting in my way. Through like this, we've got the electronics, we've got these interesting cavity covers on the back as well, where it's all one piece, which is quite unique. Now if I turn us over to the front, On this guitar, we've got quite a simple configuration. We've got a hip shot bridge, which is a kind of a non-locking tremolo, which I've been really impressed with. It feels great. I'm generally quite a fan of hip shots hardware. I've used it quite a lot. I've seen it on lots of guitars, and to be honest, they really never go wrong. This is just another great example. It's very flat across here. It feels very smooth under the picking hand. It feels extremely comfortable. It's very, very responsive when I'm playing, and the tuning stability has been great. So I've got really no complaints about this bridge whatsoever. This has also got one volume and one tone control and a three-way pickup selector. And then we've got some custom-made pickups by Steve Smith, and he calls these the Johnson Buckers. So Steve Smith is a British pickup winder, and Dan knows him personally and got him involved, and these pickups have come out fantastic, because I'll be playing for you a bit more and you'll hear. In general, Dan's trying to use British makers as much as possible for his line, which is, you know, really interesting and a bit unique. So all three of these models have actually got British-made pickups in, but from three different brands. So this one has got the Steve Smith pickups in it. This one, the red one to my right, has got the Gemini pickups in it, which is another British company. And then the purple one here has got the Oil City pickups in, which is another British pickup company. So these are three different pickup builders in the UK, and he's given us a guitar with each. So I'll play them all for you a little bit so you can hear the different sounds. But overall, the quality has been very high. I've been very impressed by the different pickups that he's provided us with. The one other feature that is common across all of his Pagan models is the coil tap. So I've got a push-pull on the volume knob, which will split the coils and give us single coil sounds for both the bridge and the neck, and obviously the split position as well. So we've got a massive range of different tones. Other nice little features that are included include Dunlop strap locks as standard, which are really some of the most popular strap locks on the market, and will just save you the effort of having to do that yourself. And they all come in MacPherson hard cases, complete with leather straps and all kinds of goodies, a little toolkit and stuff like that. And something that I thought was actually a really nice little feature is they also come with a MacPherson branded flash drive, which has got your certificate of authenticity, the warranty and everything on it, as well as a complete gallery of pictures of Dan building the guitar. So that's obviously unique for each model, and it's a really nice touch for somebody looking to invest in one of these instruments. Okay, so that's it for this guitar. Let me just quickly run you through the differences on the other two instruments. Okay, so on this purple one, this is a really good example of kind of some of the main differences that happen within the Pagan line. Probably the number one thing that players will notice is going to be the different neck profile. So Dan really focuses in on neck profiles and how different players have different tastes, because it really is a matter of taste more than anything. So on the previous one I was playing, the natural guitar, that's got a kind of a standard kind of thin D profile, which felt very modern. I think many kind of modern rock guys and the shredders will be really familiar and at home with that neck profile. This one has got a C profile, so it's got a slightly thicker C kind of profile. It's very, it's much more traditional feeling. I wouldn't call it fat or overly wide, but it's definitely much, much chunkier than the previous one, and would be comfortable for people who prefer probably more traditional designs in guitar. And then there's all kinds of just little differences on the model. So for example, the nut is bone instead of graphite. We've got different pickups, as I mentioned before. So this has got the Oil City pickups in it. It's got a fixed hip shot bridge, chrome hardware. But overall, really, apart from that, everything's very similar. It's still got the three-way, it's still got the coil tap. Most of the other kind of features of the Pagan have stayed the same in this one. Okay, so let's just quickly look at the red one, and then I'll play them for you a bit so you can hear what they sound like. Okay, so now I'm with the red Pagan guitar we've got, and I've got to say that for me personally, this is definitely the best looking of the three. I absolutely love the finish on this. So this is, again, it's Swamp Ash, but he's given it the red matte finish, and the wood's been unfilled, so you can see, I'm sure, that it's kind of textured where the grain is in the wood, and if I turn it over, you can see on the back as well, which is really, really nice. We've got a maple fretboard on this, but again, he's done the same thing with the binding. So we can see that he's taken cuts from the original fingerboard blank and used it to bind the sides of the frets so that you've got no rough fret edges. In fact, you've got no fret edges at all. And once again, this is absolutely immaculate. It looks beautiful. It's a really, really nice touch on these guitars. I really, really like it. Pretty much everything else is pretty similar to what was going on over here, although we've got the Gemini pickups in this. So that's another British band, Gemini. And I'm just going to draw your attention to something else that Dan's done, which I think is actually quite nice, is he's really focused on the kind of angle that the strings are coming off the nut to the headstock here. So he's really concentrated on trying to make sure that the string tension across the neck is the same. And you can see this really clearly here, is he's pulled these out here. Now, a lot of the times you see guitars with string through body bridges like this. They'll do it the other way around. So the bass strings will come out further and the treble strings will go up higher like here as an aesthetic thing. But when I was talking to Dan about these guitars, he made a very valid point that actually, like, the sharper the angle of the string going in, the more tension is created. So you want this to be sharper here. You want it to be shorter because you're going to be tuning this to a lower pitch. So even though it's a thicker gauge, the typical problem that a lot of players have is the kind of slightly floppy bass strings, especially if you want to drop D it or something like that. And by increasing the string pull here, you increase the tension. That's what he told me, and I must say that from playing this guitar, the string tension is absolutely spot on across the whole neck. It's very, very consistent. One other feature of these guitars that's common to all three of them, and is his standard, is he's got a compound radius going on across the fingerboard, but it's extremely wide in comparison to most compound radiuses. So he's starting off at 9.5 inch radius down here, very vintage, and by the time you get up to the top frets, he's on 16 inches. That's a vast, vast compound radius. And it really almost feels like you're playing two different guitars. When you're down here, even on this guitar, I've got a very, very traditional kind of feeling fretboard here. It's great for chord playing, that kind of stuff. And as I come up here, it's almost completely flat, it feels. And it's really, really great. It's, I don't know, it's a different feel, but it's something that Dan's gone for that I actually really enjoyed while I was playing these instruments. And of course, if that's not going to be your thing, he can do it with any kind of radius that you want. But I'd definitely recommend giving this a go because it's just a bit different. It's really kind of worked, in my opinion. One other thing I should mention about this guitar was obviously neck profile, which I kind of forgot to mention before. This is super thin, right? So this is ridiculously thin, this guitar. It's probably one of the thinnest neck profiles I've ever come across. And Dan made it basically just to prove that he could. For my personal taste, this one's actually a little bit too thin. I don't know, probably just because my hands are pretty big and I'm just feeling a bit like they're all on top of each other with it. But if thin profiles are your thing, like, he's definitely got you covered on this guitar. Okay, so without further ado, I'm just going to plug all these guitars in and just play them with a variety of different sounds. And I'll use all the different pickups, and you should see I'll tap the coils, I'll do everything so you can get a good idea of the guitars. Just in different environments, different settings, and kind of how they sound. We'll be right back.
Yeah.
Okay, so that's a pretty comprehensive overview of the three MacPherson guitars that we've got here in the studio today. Overall, these are great, great guitars, great hand-built British guitars. And it's really cool to see something just a little bit different, especially coming from a British builder. Overall, I'd definitely recommend checking these guitars out. They're obviously, you know, they're in the top range of pricing and top range of instruments. So it's really something for a serious player or somebody who's looking to invest in a serious instrument. And that's one of the great things really that's come about, I think, in the scene, probably in the last 10 years really, thanks to the internet. The exposure for small luthiers and small guitar companies has been great. And now it's considerably more common for players to be going out and looking for these more unusual builds and brands. To try out for themselves rather than just immediately investing the money on, you know, a big and well-established name. It's not for everyone, but if you're the kind of player that's looking for something that could be quite personal for you, then I'd definitely say MacPherson guitars are well worth a look for you and definitely worth checking out. So Dan has his guitars available in a shop at the moment, one shop in the country, but he's looking to expand and he mainly deals direct. So the best way to get more information would be to check out his website and contact him directly. Don't forget to read what I've written in the magazine because I'm going to write way more thoughts and stuff like that. And I'm also going to write a little bit of the history of Dan's company and Dan as a luthier and stuff like that. So the article will definitely be worth reading for some more information on these guitars. And I hope you found this useful and informative. So until next time, cheers.